The face of the modern punk. An ugly face to some, but what an eloquent and creative group of individuals they are. What they lack in grey matter between the ears, they make up for in colour on top.
Police won't leave me alone!
Who gave their lives for something never owned?
There's nothing quite like a sing-song at home, or a poetry recitation.
It's happening again! Go on, it's my birthday. I'm 18 today!
Birthday, John!
And this is a side to punkdom you won't have seen before.
You have to pay. Right.
Unless you've wandered up London's King's Road.
Do you want to come down and take some photographs? As many as you want to take for £2.
If you want any photographs, you have to pay.
These punks are business punks, ripping money out of the tourists faster than you can say, get nicked.
Come on, think about
not
it.
Not that of a trip.
Their enterprising 24-year-old leader with the Aussie ostrich haircut is Alex.
Yeah, right. How's business this morning?
Pretty good. I made about 12, 13 quid, and that was without not having any arguments with anyone. That's pretty much a strike.
If you don't get your head kicked in.
Sometimes Alex has to educate other members of the gang. Here, he's requesting an apprentice punk to be more respectful.
I told you again to if you're going to cause trouble.
After a hard day's work, it's time to go home. In their case, home for all 20 in the gang is a condemned house in Islington. They had to break in to get possession, but what a flair for interior decoration they've shown.
What about parents? How do your parents react?
My dad loves me. At first they think, you know, is it something I've done? Is it anything, you know, have I raised you wrong? Have I done something against you or anything like that, you know? And you say no, it's just, you know, you've got to prove what you feel.
Just about any type of drug is in, but glue sniffing ranks equal number one with cheap booze.
Hello!
Cyril is a glue man, and his outlook on life is invariably through a plastic bag. Even on the street, he has something up his sleeve to make work more tolerable.
The only thing that no one takes is heroin, you know, if I do, we kick them out. That's the thing that is really, really bad for you. Most people take things in moderation, you know.
There are only two rules in this house. No heroin and no glue sniffing upstairs. In this room, 10 punks bed down for the night. With names like Bumbox, Scumbag, and Animal, you can imagine the very special aroma in here. But the cosy sleeping arrangements seem to have some advantages in their eyes.
Now, what about sex?
Please,
none. Don't get enough of it.
Alex,
not enough.
I can't get enough.
You've got 20 enough. Men and women living fairly closely together in a fairly small place.
We never have sex.
Do you have a fairly free lifestyle as far as sex goes?
No.
We're not queer, that's for sure.
Fairly free, yeah.
Like so many home-loving folk, punks love pets. They have a cat. And a ready supply of cat food.
It's never bit me at all, never.
It's hard to know who stands a greater chance of contracting an infectious disease, the punks or the rats.
Excuse me, if you want a photograph, you have to pay.
What'd you say?
You have to pay for photographs.
Oh, we have to pay?
Eh?
How much?
£2. As many as you want.
Come on, you can take as many as you want for a couple of pounds.
No, I don't take any of that.
I'm taking pictures in building here.
No, you're not.
We're not stupid. They think we're thick.
Being a punk can get even the grubbiest of individuals down, and some of these punks show evidence of trying to swap their mohawk haircuts for halos. The police arrived for a bit of healthy harassment. Were they looking for a secret stock of glue? Or evidence of an orgy? Had they come to evict the lot of them and save the neighbourhood?
Alien! What's going on?
The neighbours went into deep gossip.
Have you got permission
to go? No.
But the police only wanted to find out what could possibly interest an Australian TV crew in a group of grubbies like this.
What a rude person!
I take drugs!